Hello, I am Army Chaplain Anthony Kelley, and today I want to talk to you about your hand, namely a five-finger exercise. No, not one of a physical exercise, but a spiritual five-finger exercise. Back in the early 19th century, there was a theologian with the Stone Campbell Movement, a movement to restore New Testament Christianity, go back to the New Testament, and break away from denominationalism. His name was Walter Scott. And he thought of this five-finger exercise in order for people to understand the gospel message in a simple, easy-to-understand way that even a child could understand. This five-finger exercise first starts with hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Faith comes by what? Hearing, right? So we need to hear about Jesus, to know about Jesus, to understand who Jesus was, what he did on earth, what's the gospel all about, what's the Bible all about. So you need to hear about Jesus Christ. Secondly, you need to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, that you believe in who Jesus said he was. Jesus said he was the Son of God. You need to believe that, come that faith and trust in who Jesus is, that he's taking care of your salvation and eternity. And then thirdly, you need to repent of all of your sin, to acknowledge that you are a sinner in need of God's grace and forgiveness, and that Jesus Christ can forgive you and cleanse you of all of your unrighteousness. In fact, in Acts chapter 2, the crowds asked Peter, "What shall we do to be saved?" Peter said in Acts 2:38, "Repent and be baptized, each and every one of you, for the forgiveness or remission of your sins, and you'll receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." So you need to repent of all of your sin, to acknowledge that you, yes, are a sinner in need of Jesus' forgiveness. And then you need to confess. You need to confess. Confess who Jesus is, just like Peter did when Peter was and all the disciples were being led by Jesus through the region of Caesarea Philippi. They're going to that grand Roman city, seeing all the architecture that was built in honor of Caesar Tiberius. Jesus asked two pointed questions. One, who do the people say that I am? And then after Jesus got the response of what the people thought, he asked the disciples, who do you say that I am? That's when Peter boldly, inspired from God, said, "You are the Christ, the Son of the Most High and living God." This confession is the confession that you need to make, that you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. And lastly, be water baptized by total immersion into the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. As it says in Romans chapter 6, verse 4, that baptism identifies us in Jesus Christ. Jesus himself was baptized. He commanded us in the Great Commission to be baptized and to baptize others. And so when you look at every case of conversion in the book of Acts, and that's where you will find all the conversions, whether Jew or Gentile, in the book of Acts, you will see one of these elements taking place. But all of them have water baptism by total immersion. In fact, sprinkling and pouring did not occur to the church till after the first century. So the first century mode, the Bible mode to be able to receive salvation involved water baptism by total immersion into the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. I encourage each and every one of you to seek out the scriptures and find out how to be saved in order to help others find that salvation in Jesus Christ. And if you have not completed this five-finger exercise, at least have not completed baptism, I encourage you to find a good Bible-believing New Testament church to baptize you immediately. I pray for each and every one of you to find peace in Jesus Christ, to find salvation in Jesus Christ. It starts with this five-finger exercise that Walter Scott thought of himself through the scriptures. And it all comes from the book of Acts. I hope you have a great and marvelous day. In Jesus' name, amen.